Iguodala to Curry, back to Iguodala, up for the layup. Oh, blocked by James. LeBron James with the rejection.
Wow. Because this is a career-long attempt for Tyler Durbin, who's super reliable inside of 40. This is from 45, and it's blocked. Lions scoop it up.
They'll give it to Singleton to the 15, 20, Singleton 25, 30. He's to the 40, he's to the 50. Goodbye, he is gone. Nicholas Singleton to the house. 87 yards.
Pickett.
Cannot be stopped.
It's Zach.
And Prawn, that's the name.
It's the Zap Show right now.
Ooh, ooh, that intro, Zach. That intro, buddy.
It's the Zap Show. Zach Donaldson, Toby Prime, Zach and Prime, the Zap Show.
That's the name, man. Don't wear it out. I mean, that intro, Zach, beautifully done. I mean, electric calls. Shout out to you who made it. And also a couple calls that you put in there. I like that. Steve Jones as well. We always love Steve Jones. We are Penn State, but love that. Jimmy Cook's Electric Factory. What a way to start.
Yeah, the song, usually it takes me a while to pick a song, but we got some history with that song. So
yeah, we do.
It was kind of didn't think twice. And yeah, the calls, got to throw our man Steve Jones, Penn State legend in there.
Legend, dude, legend. I mean, we both took his class, too. He taught us all we needed to know, baby.
I'd like to say he's a bit of my mentor. Because, yeah, we're starting this podcast here. Zach, Toby, Prime, what do you want to go by?
Right?
I mean,
yeah,
I like
Prime. I like Prime Time. I like that a lot. But I do appreciate Toby. The only reason why I don't like Toby is because people spell my name wrong. My mom tried to be fancy and threw the E in there, and everybody just calls me Toby, T-O-B-Y. So Prime is just easier. It's just way easier.
I like it better with the E for what it's worth.
Yeah, you know, my mom was cute like that. Shoot, like that.
But yeah, we're just two recent graduates of Penn State University trying to break into the sports industry, the broadcasting world, and whether it be play-by-play or whether it be podcasting like this. I shouldn't even say broadcasting world, more sports media landscape in whatever, you know, medium it may be. But, you know, summer's over, football season is ramping up, and we were both talking. We were like, hey, you know, if we're both trying to do something media-wise this season, let's put our heads together and let's make it one. Let's do this thing.
Yeah, dude, mine as well with how everything's in. And might as well be another voice. And, I mean, you and I have done a lot of things together, and we've always created magic. But, like, it always stopped because whether it was a sports team or a project, now we're out in the ocean. We're no longer in the Happy Valley Pond, you know? So now it's – let's just do it. So I'm excited. There's going to be a lot of interesting takes and probably a lot of bad ones as well from yours truly. But you will be entertained. You will be entertained. That's for sure.
That is a fact. Good takes and bad takes. We'll sprinkle a little bit of both in for you.
Yeah, well, yeah. It can't always be good. Can't always be good.
Yeah, but yeah, I did. I mean, I did the thing. I had my own show on Com Radio, Sports with a Z, and you know, I did the thing by myself because my former co-host graduated. I didn't really like it that much with myself, and I've said this on air. But when you were in there, and when Matt Brown were in there, I mean, man, we had the chemistry was off the charts. It was fireworks. So how could we not run this back?
Exactly. Like an hour show felt like 5 minutes. It did. It was just the banter was awesome. Yeah. But yeah, man, you said it yourself, though. It's the greatest time of year where summer is ending, the fall, the leaves are changing, and football has started. And we had a fantastic weekend for college football.
It was definitely one to remember for me.
Yeah, I mean, let's just dive right into it. Let's not pitter-patter anymore. I want to hear your, I think, one of the best games, if not the most watched game of this weekend, was seeing Coach Prime. No relation. I wish Dion was distant, but we just share the nickname, I guess. But I want to hear, like, just kind of general thoughts. Did you watch that game? I know you're up in Happy Valley, but.
Yeah, well, we rented a RV. My brother goes to West Virginia.
Ooh.
Sophomore West Virginia, so we had a little rivalry going on right there. And their Nittany Lions are in Morgantown next year, so it's going to continue, which is awesome. But I was up there. We rented an RV, and my dad was prepared. He got, like, this dish satellite thing. It's like a portable satellite and gives off a signal. So we had all the games there. The TV was, like, built for the RV. Such a great time. But, yeah, we did catch that Colorado game. I mean, it was the best one on the early window easily. Mm-hmm. And I would say it's probably the best one of the weekend.
Yeah. No, I would agree with you. Just kept going back and forth.
The 20 and a half point spread, though.
Did you bet that?
I may or may not have hit two parlays this weekend.
Hey, that's what we like. That's what we like.
Start to football season on the gambling side of things, and I did have Colorado's spread in there. It was sweat free, like it was awesome. And Sanders, just he's a baller.
Dude, he's I don't know how he nuts. He was nuts, bro. And it honestly made me, like, very happy. So, yeah, Colorado. So my dad and I were talking about this, and I was like, he was a big fan. I guess there was a Coach Prime documentary about primetime. I didn't watch that. I should watch that. But he, like, is not a fan of Dion after this because he's like, all he did was he took all the good players from Jackson State and he put them all to Colorado. I'm like, Dad, you go from an HBCU to a Power 5 conference. Like, this is good for the kids. Like, he's giving them, like, a bigger stage or whatever, but he didn't get past that. And I was like, Dad, you should have watched this game, though, because Colorado, they're legit, dude. You talk about Sanders' son. He had a crazy game. But really, I think everybody got to know Hunter, Travis Hunter, bro. Like, he became literally a college football name, if not one of the Heisman favorites behind Caleb Williams after this weekend. My question for you is, obviously, he is literally another prime. He's another Deion Sanders out there playing both corner and wide receiver. What do you think is his better position? Because there's no way he can do that in the NFL.
Yeah, I saw a ridiculous, like, statistic that his, based off of his snap average in the week one game, he would end the season with, like, over 4,500 snaps, which is more than, like, some NFL teams play in an entire season, which is absurd. You probably can't do that at the next level. I don't want to say never, but that's just too much on somebody's body. And I think he might be a better cornerback, but wide receiver is the easier position to play. So, you know, it's just one game. We're going to have to see, you know, where he, you know, really puts his nose to the grindstone and where he really wants to play, I think.
Yeah. No, I agree with you, dude. I think let me just say, TCU, I know they're in the championship game. They had three players that started against Colorado that were on that championship team. So this is not this. Like, I don't want to discredit Colorado. I mean, they only had one win last year, so, like, good for them. Good, it's definitely a good win on the road. But this TCU team, they're they're going to drop out of the top 25 rankings, honestly, and I don't think they'll get back. I don't think they're like that, all that. But I think going back to Travis, I think he's a better corner, 100%. The things that he was doing in the red zone and doing all that, I just think he's got great chemistry with Shador right now, where, like, he's like, literally when the game was on the line, he threw it to Travis. He had that big catch on, like, a long third down or fourth down, whatever it was. But I think he's going to be a better corner. But for now, when you're 18 years old and you have all that energy, he even said after the game, oh, no, I'm ready to go again. Like, go ahead, dude. Go ahead and ball out. Like, put up video game numbers. Like, that's what we want to see as fans. Like, that's so awesome.
Yeah.
But even their running back, Edwards, he's very good. I just think, like, I just like prime time. I like the way he coaches. There's a lot of videos that came after the game of, like, the pregame speech and all that. He was like, there's no more coming. Like, we're here now. Like, we're here. We ain't got to prove anything. Now let's go out there and show our work. And I just think it's awesome. He got a lot of hate throughout the offseason, my dad included. But it doesn't matter, dude. He proved kind of everybody wrong, and Rado's going to be legit.
Absolutely. You mentioned Coach Prime's coaching style. He was on the Pat McAfee show this morning, I think, and he had the little engine that could, the book, and he brought it on and he showed him, and he's like, Pat, you know this book? He's like, that's a little engine that could. That's what I told the guys. He's like, we can do this. We can do this. You can do this. And I just think he's a player's coach. Like, he's the epitome of a player's coach. He just gets what these guys are going through. He gets how to connect with them. And it definitely helps that his son is the star quarterback. I mean, you talk about video game numbers by Travis Hunter. 510 passing yards for Sanders. 38 completions. They were the most by any quarterback in week one. And 90.6 QBR, 4 passing touchdowns, 1 on the ground. I mean,
insane.
Yeah,
insane.
He put himself on the map.
Yeah.
If he wasn't already on the map. But he I think he people are going to start to seriously consider him as a, you know, quarterback.
Yeah.
A legit NFL prospect, too.
Yeah. I think the coolest thing, too, is that their colors are just sick. Like, in a visually appeasing way, Colorado's, like, black and gold. I mean, come on now. Like, that's a hit.
Buffaloes.
Yeah, dude. So, shout out. They were definitely, like, the winners of the weekend, 100%. Easy. I give it to Colorado.
It was, like, the only big upset outside of Texas or Arkansas. No, Texas State over Georgia. Or Georgia, over Baylor.
Yeah. All the other ones kind of went expected. I mean, another game, like Ohio State and Indiana. Ohio State should have handled them, but they kept it close.
Yeah, definitely. And 23-3, I think the final was.
Yeah, and I saw, like, Marvin Harrison, I think he only had two catches or something like that. Yeah. I know he got hurt, but I think he's fine. That was interesting for at least me to see. I didn't really watch that game because Indiana is a snooze fest, in my opinion. But also, I just have a disdain towards Ohio State. But it's interesting now they don't have, like, a elite kind of top quarterback now, it seems like, in the great state of Ohio. But, that was the only other game I can really think of where I was shocked by the final score. I mean, but then we had blowouts, too.
Yeah,
we had some
butt whoopings.
Yeah, I mean, Oklahoma, bro. Like, think about Arkansas State. You prepare all winter, all summer, spring, all that for the first game. And not only do you not score a single point, you get blown out 73. Put 73 points on your defense. Like, you got to be questioning everything. What do you even say, like, the media? Like, if anything, like, if I'm in that media room as the head coach, I'm just like, yeah, guys, we can suck. What else do you want to know? Everything was bad. There's, like, no stories, I feel like, to come out of that. But,
I mean, I didn't watch it. I didn't even look at the stats. I just saw the final score. I was like, oh, my God.
Yeah, dude.
Oregon, that wasn't even the highest score of the weekend. Oregon put up 81. And their mascot had to do, like, 746 push-ups.
At what point are you, like, as a mascot, and put yourself in the mascot shoes, at what point are you like, all right, I'm not doing any more push-ups, guys. Like, come on, this is ridiculous. Like, you thinking like 500? 200?
750 push-ups.
Yeah, like, what's your cap, though? Like, when are you like, I'm not doing this? Yeah, you personally.
Ugh. See, I don't know how many... I always do my push-ups, like, post at the end of my workout. I find that as, like, a good, like, cool-down exercise. I could probably at least do 250.
Okay. That's respectable.
But after that, I'd probably be like, what's the point of this? Like,
especially you're in that big-ass mascot costume. Because what are they? It's the ducks. Yeah, it's a big old duck. You're in a big old duck costume.
Week two.
Like, I want to know how that mascot. I wanted a post-game press conference. Maybe in like the post-morning of like, hey, man, how are you feeling? You got to be sore.
Like, that's a chest day for all chest days right there.
Oh, 100%. Like, I wouldn't hit chest for like another 2 weeks. But no, I'm good.
Oh, man.
But yeah, dude, that's insane. I mean, what if it was the Nittany Lion? He's doing one arm push-ups, which 750 one arms would be nuts.
That can't be humanly possible.
Yeah, no way.
I wouldn't even think 750 is humanly possible. That guy's got to be pretty fit.
Yeah, he's got to be ripped.
Like, I think I'm pretty fit, and I couldn't do 750.
Oh yeah, no shot. Yeah, I couldn't do that. No way. No way.
Especially in a suit, man. God bless that dog. Whatever.
What is it?
Puddles or paddles or something.
What is it, like 10? What does he do, like 25 per touchdown? Like, how did he get to 750?
It's like, math. All right, so it's like, so they score, say they score 7. So he does the 7. And then they score another 10. So he does like 17.
Okay. That makes a lot of sense. I feel you.
Does that make sense?
Yeah. No, yeah. No, that makes
sense. I can see it in my head, 'cause I was wondering the same thing, and somebody, I just read a reply on Twitter.
Okay. So it's not like 7 after, like you're like adding it all up. It's like 7 plus the score. Damn.
Yeah, you repeat. Yeah.
Damn.
So when they had 74 or whatever, and when they scored the 80 touch, he had to do like what they had before and then like the 81.
Godspeed, bro. I just hope that man's doing well.
Yeah.
But then we had another, well, I guess another game, is, I wouldn't really call it an upset between 5 and 9, but I mean, FSU went into, or LSU came and visited FSU and got smacked around. Mm-hmm. And I put money on that, and I have a massive parlay of like all the top teams to win it all. And, it died after that LSU game.
Rip. I said I was 2 for 2 on my parlays. My Sunday one was Rutgers to cover, took it to Northwestern, Oregon State to cover. DJU looked really nice. Speaking of quarterbacks, there's a lot of stud quarterbacks here.
Yeah, dude.
But and then Jordan Travis and Jaden Daniels, who I don't think he's anything special. I thought Jordan Travis was the better quarterback last night, and he showed it in the second half. I mean, those halftime adjustments that Florida State made, they were evident in the first half. They were right there. They had the size advantage with the receivers on the outside, and they put that two back look in the backfield, and they started getting that ground game going, and Jordan Travis started to lock in after that. He was feeling the pressure well, delivering tough balls to his big targets. Keon Coleman, Michigan State transfer, put himself on the map for sure last night too. 3 big touchdowns.
They got that swagger back, bro. I think they're college football. Like, I think they're playoff. They're a playoff team after what I saw.
I was very impressed with that win.
Yeah, dude. Like that, and like I like when it's not
over LSU. That's happened.
Yeah, but it's also
Brian Kelly's LSU.
Yeah, well, Brian Kelly's a joke show because he went there and all of a sudden got a southern accent after being at Notre Dame. Like, he's a clown, in my opinion.
doing TikToks.
Yeah, the little 360. I saw that today. I was like, again. On, I was like, man. I was like, come on, man. Like, what is that, bro? But
not a Brian Kelly guy.
Yeah.
Plus, no, he killed a kid. So.
Whoa. Whoa.
Have you not heard that?
No, I didn't.
Oh.
What's the tea on that?
Look, when he was at Notre Dame, there was like a kid. I think he was like a team like videographer or something. And I forget the exact story, but Kelly like told him to. Kelly like wouldn't let him go in or something when he said the conditions were unsafe, and he like fell off like a high rise or something like that. But yeah, and he unfortunately passed away.
Wow, jeez, Brian Kelly. Yeah, now another reason I don't like him. Jeez, but we'll
drop our first bit of tea here on.
Yeah, dude, you learn something new every day, folks. I didn't even know that.
Yeah, so if some listeners weren't aware. I probably skewed some of those details on that story, but it is a thing.
I'll take the gist of it.
Rest that poor kid's soul.
Anyways.
Lighthearted stuff.
Yeah, I mean, why don't we go into what we really wanted to talk about here? You were there. So before we even get to the game, personally, when I watched it, I was at my house, so I was in the comfort of my own home. But when I looked at the TV, I was like, man, I can't believe, like, I'm not there. Like, I'm not a student there anymore. Like, I'm an alum now. I felt old. Then they panned to the student section, and then I really felt old. And I'm like, I'm 22 years old. I shouldn't be feeling old. But I want to say, from a stadium aspect, how did it feel for you being an alum back there? And also, how were the new announcers? Because I know Dean DeVore retired, and we have new guys up there. So what was that about?
Man, it was definitely different being in there as an alum, but it was a good different.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say I woke up this morning at the game, and I just went on a walk. Actually, we ran out of water in our RV like on the first night.
So, yikes.
We had to, like, it was porta potties from there on out, because, like, a couple people took showers and they didn't realize, like, how fast the water drains in RVs, which is it's very quick unless you don't have it hooked up from, like, an outer source. But anyways, I went on a walk just the morning just to feel out the vibes, and, man, it took, like, 2 minutes from when I, like, exited that porta potty and could, like, breathe the Happy Valley air. There is nothing like a Happy Valley game day when you're a student, but it has that same special feeling when you're an alum. And the We Are chant, you actually kind of embrace it. Like, yeah. I thought it was kind of annoying when I was a student because you hear it every day, like at the hub, classrooms, whatever. But I heard that first one in the morning, and I was like belting it out.
Just screamed Penn
loud,
State.
Loud, baby.
Screamed Penn State. Did somebody at least say a thank you to you then? You give them a you're welcome?
Oh, someone started it, and I just joined in. Hey, I didn't start it. But,
okay.
But, you know, the sentiment is the same.
Yeah.
It's a special place, man. And the game itself was electric. 110,700 people.
Fourth
in history.
Crazy, bro. That's insane.
It was unspeakable, and they covered. So,
and they covered at the end.
It was right in front of me.
Yeah, shout out to Bo. Everybody's like, "Oh, they should have kneeled." Blah, blah, blah. No, man. This is college football, man. This ain't no.
You're the backup quarterback who, you know, technically wasn't the backup until like a couple days before, you know, game day.
Yeah.
You know. Anyways, could have a chance to have a career for himself somewhere down the line, you're going to want to go in and punch that ball in.
Oh, 100%.
And it was a rushing play on third down.
Yeah, just make the tackle.
Make a tackle.
It's not like they didn't have, it's not like he just walked in. No, he broke tackles and got in there. Like, smash mouth, baby.
He looked really good on the ground.
Yeah, he did.
He looks nice with his legs. Which that could be a weapon for Penn State. I mean, goodness, something happens to Drew, or even if something doesn't happen to Drew, you know?
Yeah. I mean, I noticed a lot, so that first touchdown had to be awesome. Like, I had an announcer moment. I was with some of my buddies, and literally, like, when that play happened, I was like, welcome to the Drew Aller era. Like,
dude,
Happy Valley.
The same thing.
Yeah.
I said the same exact thing.
And the announcer literally said the exact same thing. And I was like, I could do this. But I was like, for like all the hype and all the talk and everybody, just the anticipation around Drew Aller, for him, for that to be his first touchdown as a starter in Happy Valley, primetime game, like, it was just, I almost wanted to cry. It was so beautiful.
Dude, I swear to God, same. It was on the other side of the field from where I was sitting. KLS scored, which he's going to have a big breakout year too.
Mm-hmm.
But it was just, you said it best, like, it was just a beautiful culmination of all of that constant hype throughout last season and the off season. And it was kind of like, oh baby, here we go. Like, it was just an absolutely exhilarating start to the Aller era.
Yeah.
And I turned to, because I said my brother went to West Virginia. He didn't go into the game with me, but a couple of his friends did. And I turned to them, and I said that. I said, welcome to the Aller era, baby. It's here.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I thought it was cute that West Virginia tried to say that they could catch us sleeping or whatever.
Everyone always thinks that.
And I was like, guys, there's levels to this. Like, you're not even like a little brother. You're like a nephew from like the third part of the family that – we don't really like all too much, and we just had to show you how a top dog plays. I will say, I wish they would have beat them by a lot more. First game of the year, blah, blah, blah. But back to the West Virginia point, it's a primetime game, season opener at Beaver Stadium, the most electric atmosphere. Sorry, but no team except maybe like a Michigan or whatever would beat us at that time. Yeah. No way. There's no way. But I'm glad they covered. Needed that. Because that one of that part, my parlay hit there. Penn State won me some money. So, needed that.
You need the style points for the end of the year anyways. The beauty pageant at the end of the year. The top four finishers.
And Bo's going to remember that touchdown for the rest of his life, dude. There's something about scoring a touchdown in Beaver Stadium under the lights. Just means more. Just means more.
Franklin taking care of the fans, too. He knew it.
Yeah, he knew. He knew it was 20 and a half. He knew it.
Inside kick, so like, also, exactly.
Like,
game away. Like, if you're trying to say it's not over, I put it away then.
Yeah.
There's no argument there.
Enough glazing for a little bit. I do. So there, I had some thoughts as far as Penn State. Drew Aller really impressed me. I think he played very well. I think our wide receivers, whatever. We didn't see a lot of tight end. I didn't see a lot of Theo Johnson. I don't know if that was part of the game plan or not, but I'd like to see. We have a pretty deep tight end room. I'd like to see a little bit more of that. I did notice as well, they didn't really have Drew run the ball as much. Franklin did a lot with that, with Clifford and Trace. Didn't kind of just saw him slinging, which I'm all about. Not opposed to at all. But like literally like when Bo came in, he was running it all. So that was just something I saw it noted. Defensively is where I'm a little bit concerned, but I'm not worried because it's the first game of the year, like, and you're playing, you know, West Virginia is not like what the SEC school plays, like their little Lutheran Baptist community college. Like, West Virginia's Power 5 conference, like, they're not like they're gonna upset us, but they're a good team. So I was just a little worried defensively. Abdul Carter was kind of like a big name that he made like a couple plays, but there were a couple missed tackles and missed reads where everybody was just kind of like, he is arguably the best player on the roster. And I didn't really see that out of him. Will he bounce back and play insane the next week against Delaware? Probably, because that's just usually what happens with my sports takes. But like I think our secondary was great. I liked our front four. my stepdad told me, because he was at the game, he was looking at West Virginia, and he was like, the West Virginia linemen were just, like, massive and compared to the whatever front seven for Penn State, but they still did a good job. I'm just, for everybody that was hyping up Drew Aller, they were also hyping up how great this defense is, saying it's going to be one of the best Penn State defenses we've ever seen, just how deep they are across the board. And there was just, for all the hype, I expected to see more. But at the same time, it's week one, you know, so not worried, just a little concerned.
Yeah, I think going off the week one thing, I think offensively, I don't think we saw even half of Penn State's playbook. I think that was evident. I don't know if Drew's going to be a runner, though.
He doesn't have to be.
I don't think he moves that well. He doesn't have to be. I don't think he moves well running-wise. But when he's out of the pocket, but inside the pocket, dude's like Houdini.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's the best when the play breaks down. It's like a little Pat Mahomes-esque to a less dazzling degree, but like that first play, just that was Drew Aller in a nutshell. The play breaks down. He keeps his eyes downfield, steps up in the pocket, and KLS broke a tackle.
Mm-hmm.
So I think hopefully the playbook expands and hopefully we get to see a little bit more. Defensively, totally agree with you on Carter. He's a monster. I think it was first game.
He
was playing like a little too fast.
Yes.
Virginia players too. It was a clear athletic advantage for Penn State.
Mm-hmm.
Theoretically West Virginia scored on Penn State's second stringers. So I wasn't really that concerned about the defense, I'll be honest.
Yeah. I just for everything that I was hearing, I was just like, well, like, they didn't do anything necessarily bad.
Mm-hmm.
It was just, like, just some of those plays, like, if you want to separate yourselves with, like, not Penn Staters, but to the nation, you kind of need to separate yourself a little bit more. But, like I said, like, I'm not worried that they won't bounce back and do – I mean, it's Manny Diaz. It's one of the best defensive coordinators in the nation. I know he's going to make sure they're going to clean that up, you know. But that's a good point about Abdul – kind of playing too fast. I did notice that a little bit. But that's fine. That's just something that he's going to adjust to. It's why you do it against West Virginia. And it's why you do it early in the year. And that's why you kind of schedule these games to give yourself, you know, some practice. But you're really just waiting for the big boys. And that's going to be Michigan and Ohio State, really.
My biggest discrepancy was in the red zone. I thought we were pretty bad in the red zone.
Yeah.
Early on. And obviously kicking. We didn't talk about kicking.
Yeah, well, dude.
Kicking needs to be figured out.
Like, what was that? First off, I can't trust a lefty kicker, man. It just doesn't look right.
Looks weird.
It doesn't look right on a football field, dude.
It does. It's just it's like a lefty quarterback. Lefties just look a little funky.
Yeah. But yeah, I don't know what was up with that.
We missed it. He's a high recruit. Like I'm pretty sure he was a 4-star when we got him.
Didn't play like a 4-star.
No, he didn't. But Sam Ficken also missed all – I think he was 1-for-5 on field goals and missed an extra point in his Penn State debut. So
and turned out to be pretty nice, so – yeah, we'll see. I mean, Franklin was talking about that there was more competition at kicking than there was at quarterback. So I hope there's still competition now, man. That's inexcusable.
Facts. I mean, hopefully that just, you know, iron sharpens iron. Hopefully that someone takes the reins. And
again, hopefully it's just first game jitters. I mean, it would intimidate me, bro. 110,000, your first game under the lights. That would intimidate me a little bit, but you got to figure that shit out, bro.
Yeah. First game, you got the dub. That's all that matters.
Exactly. 1-0. 1-0. Franklin loves that.
Same thing next week. Same thing next week. I miss him, but I don't.
Who?
Frank.
No, dude. He
as
stunk.
As a press press member.
Yeah, he tells you everything but nothing at the same time.
The walking cliche. Everything but nothing is the best way to put it.
Like, you ask a question and he answers a different question, and then you're like, whoa, what the heck, dude? You didn't anything to me.
There might be something in there I can work with, but probably not.
Yeah, probably not. Thankfully, I only covered one football game, and I was like, I don't think I could do this for a full season. That's why I appreciated the basketball. Shrewsbury was...
The players, you need to get the players.
Oh, yeah, dude, the players were awesome. Players were awesome. But, yeah, dude, I like it, though. That's a good win. They covered. Yeah. Good teams win, great teams cover, and Penn State's a great team. Yeah, that's all I got to really say about Penn State. Oh, also, like, Singleton and Allen, oh, my God, I miss them. I missed watching them play football. They're so awesome.
They didn't have to do much. Like, it was a cool first win. Like, took care of business.
Took care of business. On to the next one.
Yes, sir. On to the next.
So, like, who are you thinking right now? Top five Heisman people. Kind of more going back generic all college football. Who are, like, your top five names for Heisman?
Off week one. I was going off the top. Shador, Travis Hunter, Michael Penix Jr. at a beefy stat line for Washington.
Mm-hmm.
He had a good game. Drake May, Jordan Travis.
Not even going to mention.
Wait, did I forget?
I think you're forgetting one of the biggest names, but that's fine.
This is off the cuff. Am I forgetting it? Definitely Drake May. I threw Jordan Travis in there. Who am I forgetting?
He's going to be the quarterback for the Cardinals next season.
Oh, Caleb. Cool.
Caleb. I also like that.
He played last week. Like, I forgot that they.
Yeah, I mean, they already played two games already.
Two butt whoopings.
I also like Notre Dame's quarterback.
The Wake Forest transfer.
Sam Hartman?
Sam Hartman.
Yeah, I like Sam Hartman a lot.
He looked good versus Navy. I thought that they might start off a little shaky, but he looks solid.
Yeah, I don't really like giving too much props to Notre Dame, though, because I just think they're pansies. Because they won't join a conference. So, like, they always play. I mean, they do get these primetime games, but everybody always – it's always the same story with Notre Dame every single year. They get so much hype. They win all these games against bullcrap schools. Then once they get their first true test at the end of the year, they just fold, and they're terrible. They're like, oh, what happened to Notre Dame? And it's like, it's every year. This is an every year thing for Notre Dame. And I just – but I will say they got a good quarterback. So there you go. Fighting Irish
best
fans.
One in a while.
In a while. Yeah.
Better than Ian Book, Kaiser.
Kaiser. Oh my God. You are Kaiser. Unlocking a memory for me.
Well, go Cleveland Brown for a while.
I also do love Freeman, their coach. Marcus, big fan.
Yeah. Solid dude.
Especially when that whole Brian Kelly stuff happening, and you know, he took it well, and his team seems to love him, so that's probably the only love I'll give Notre Dame. Might as well be on the first show, because that'll be it.
You won't find none from this end either, so.
I respect hockey. They're in the Big Ten, but then again, there's 8 hockey teams, or whatever. There's nobody plays hockey in college, but regardless. I like that list. I like that Heisman list a lot.
Yeah, I was going to say, give me yours. Give me yours before we...
I mean, Caleb, Travis, Shador, Bias. I'm throwing Alar in there. I think that might be one of his worst games of the year. Yeah. I think he's just going to torch up the league. And I like Penix, too. I'm glad, literally, if you saw my reaction, I like that, too. Wasn't he in the Big Ten? Wasn't he... did he start at the Big Ten? Do you know what school he was at?
Oh, that looked... My hand looked real close up there. I was trying to reenact the touchdown stretch.
Oh, yes. That's how I remember him. Yeah. Yeah, dude. Oh, yeah. 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 Oh, that is a painful memory. But, yeah, I like that. I like that for right now.
That's always who he's going to be for me.
What,
his day did not get in.
Yeah, he was not in. He was not in. But that photo haunted me. That was the COVID year, right?
That was the COVID year. It was the first game.
And we were... Yeah, we were.
Penn State won that game. That year would have been totally different. I stand by that.
Mm-hmm.
That set a bad tone for the year.
Yeah, bad.
It was already a bad tone with no fans in the stands.
Yeah, and then you get the – yeah. Let's do final one. Who's your – who do you think is going to be playoff? I can start if you want me to.
Yeah, based off of week one?
Yeah, based off of week one. All right. I think I'm going to go – Bama, Michigan, Florida State, Penn State. I think in that order. After week one, thoughts.
Yeah. Honestly, I would probably say Bama, Texas next week.
It's going to be a great game. It's going to be a great game.
Probably Bama. I almost want to say the exact same four as you.
Say
USC instead of Michigan. I don't think Michigan is. I don't like JJ McCarthy that much. I don't know if he's got it.
But my only problem is that like I can't see like they, I think they're just gonna win the Big Ten. Like I've said this before. I think Penn State's gonna go 11-1. They're gonna beat Ohio State and lose to Michigan, and then they're gonna win the Big Ten title. And they're probably going to be like a second seed. I don't like JJ either, but they have a killer defense and the best running back in the country. So that's why I'm high on them. Like I hate Michigan, but I have to respect the talent. I thought you were going to be spicy and throw Rado in there. A little hot take. I thought you were going to be go hard, all in.
I didn't think about it. Shit. After week one, It's tough to know, but at the same time, like it's been kind of chalk for the most part. Like, I mean, you always have Bama, and then there's Georgia, and then there's
yeah.
I don't think it'll be LSU though. I don't think it'll be Clemson.
I do like the USC pick though. I wasn't even thinking that, but yeah. I mean,
13-0 in week one. The only time a conference has ever gone 13-0 in college.
It's a shame that they're just going to blow up this year.
It's their last chance to do it, though.
Yeah.
History, and they did it.
You got to be, like, upset if you're, like, the Pac-12 president and you're like, wow. Yeah. Or maybe happy. You'd be like, well, at least we can end it on a good note. But yeah, dude, that is insane. You told me that. I didn't even know that they all won. Like, that's awesome.
Yeah. Oregon State capped it off on Sunday. I like Sunday college football when there's not NFL.
When there's not NFL, yeah. But they only get 1 week of that, so.
That changes this week, baby.
I'm so excited, man.
3 days.
I'm so excited.
Kick off the season, which is an electrifying, like, kickoff game. Like, that should be points, points, points.
Like, yeah, dude.
I think I like 35-32, like Chiefs win or something like that.
I like the Lions, man. Dan Campbell,
I think
culture guy. He's a culture guy. Yeah, I still think Chiefs win it though. All respect, but I think Chiefs are in like a weird spot for me right now, where I always respect a champion. I know I didn't put Georgia in my top four, but that's because they didn't. Half their team got drafted. Anyways, Chiefs to me, obviously I'm not going to count them out because Super Bowl champs, you got Pat Mahomes and Kelsey. Like, that's deadly. But they're not – it looks like they're not going to have Chris Jones. He wants more money, and Chiefs don't want to give it to him. Not like they still won't torch the regular season, but if they don't have Chris Jones, dude, like, he's – like, they're silent, like, killer, bro. Like, he is an amazing end. And I think, like, without him, like, Chiefs might lose a game or two because of his absence. Not saying
defense
they still
haven't been their strength, anyways.
Yeah, exactly.
I think I always view Chris Jones as like two guys on the line.
Yeah,
one. Like he just makes that much of an impact.
There's only a few players. There's only a few players like Chris Jones. I mean, you're talking Micah, TJ, Bosa, Donald. I mean, I know they're all better than Chris Jones, but like as far as impact goes for a team, like you have to game plan for guys like that. You can't just throw a line out there and say push him. Be like, no, we have to look at how his tendencies are. Yeah, so I don't know. But I think Chiefs win that one.
Should.
I'm very excited for the boys. Okay. The boys in Pittsburgh. I am amped up for this season. I will go on record right now. We ain't winning no Super Bowl. That's the analytic kind of non-biased brain. But if you talk to Bias T Prime, we're winning the whole damn thing. And I want a Pennsylvania battle for the Super Bowl. I want that. I need
Beaver
that.
Stadium.
In Beaver would be Beaver. Crazy. Oh, it would be insane. But, I'm excited about them. I want to hit you with, like, I don't want to go game by game. I want to hit you with surprise question. I want you to give me, we'll start with this one first, three teams that you think were bad last year that you think will make a big jump and will be either Super Bowl contending or playoff teams. What are your three most surprising teams that will be good?
Let me think. So, last year... Who's in the playoffs last year?
Yeah, I had to sprung this one up on you. I didn't want you to prepare for this one.
No, you're totally fine. Just let me see who is in the playoffs.
I mean, I can help you out with one. It's pretty easy.
The Jets?
Jets, yeah. I like that.
Like, the Jets were the first one that came. I feel like that's like low-hanging fruit, though. You think you're going to be that much better?
I think we'll make the playoffs. It'll be a wild card team.
I think you could sneak it. AFC North is good.
Dude, AFC North is very good. Everybody says Steelers are going to be last. I don't think Steelers are going to be last.
Like, it depends on how. I mean, Lamar's got to stay healthy. I mean, obviously everybody's got to stay healthy, but that's been his big like kryptonite is him staying on the field. Watson, like, this is Watson's either going to gain a little bit more respect this year or become
he's stanky, bro.
Tiny bit of respect. But always going to become a laughing stock.
Yeah.
If he stinks it up, which I kind of hope he does, then he's going to become a laughing stock. Which he kind of already is.
Yeah.
But, you know, he's got one of the biggest contracts in the NFL, and the Browns seem to still believe in him. So he has some credibility.
Yeah.
I do like the Steelers. I love Kenny Pickett. I love when he got drafted. Love George Pickens. I mean, in Pat Freiermuth, that's like a 10-year like staple trio right there.
And then on the other side, JPJ, like just the story of that is sweet.
He had a good preseason.
Yeah, he had a great preseason. Got an interception, which is something I don't think we ever saw at Penn State. I don't think he ever got one. It could be maybe one.
I think you're right. At least last year, because it was like Zaki Wheatley and Kalen King. Johnny Dixon got a bunch of them. I don't think he ever did get one.
Yeah, I mean, they didn't really test him all that much because they knew. But he had a lot of PBUs, which is what people like to say. But yeah, then you got TJ, and you got, I think, one of the most slept on mans in the league is Alex Highsmith. If you don't know him now, you will get to know him. Pat Pete, Minka. I think it'll be solid. Anyways, I don't want to keep glazing all that. So I got Jets, I got Steelers. You got another team?
I'm going through my divisions here.
Cuz I like the Saints.
Yeah. I was thinking the Saints. just because I think Derek Carr is a good quarterback.
I think Derek Carr is a great quarterback, and I think that division is, like, poopy. It is poopy.
it's bottom of the porta potty.
Yeah, dude, it is poopy. And, like, he has a lot of weapons out there, and their defense is still very great. Mm-hmm. I like the Saints a lot.
Front office, yeah.
Same division. I can maybe see Tampa Bay. Like, I only because I know it's Baker. Say what you want about Baker. But when you have Godwin and Evans to throw to, kind of makes your job as a quarterback a little bit easier. But then again, like, I really don't know how that's, because Baker could also just, you know, poop the bed as well, and all of a sudden they're pretty trash.
You don't know what Baker Mayfield you're going to get.
Like, yeah.
That's the thing.
If I'm them, dude, I don't know why they don't bring back the boy Winston. Bring him back to the Bucks.
Is he not on the team?
He's on the Saints. He's the backup. Yeah, he's backing up. I think Jameis is a starting caliber quarterback. I don't think he'll win you a Super Bowl, but you'll have a lot of, like, bonehead, but also crazy highlights. So
he's been better since he got LASIK surgery.
Yeah, true.
He couldn't see for half of his career,
which is so hilarious.
At least he got it fixed.
Another team, I think the Lions as well. But they have, that's Ben building. Like, I think. Yeah, plus, you have.
They were bad last year. Like, they almost made the playoffs.
Like, Green Bay is going to be bad. You really only have the Vikings. I'm not sold on Justin Fields. Yeah, I don't know how you feel about Justin Fields.
I'm not. No.
I'm not.
His legs are electrifying. Like, he could set records with his legs. But I also think this year teams will game plan a little bit more for that.
Oh, yeah.
He's got to bring it with his arm. He has DJ Moore.
Yeah.
And I think they got him another weapon too. But
I mean, they got Claypool.
Oh yeah, they got Chase Claypool. But that was at the end of last year.
Yeah.
I think they got somebody else.
I think I can't think of him, but I think you're right. Yeah, I gotta pull up these divisions. My next question would be, who do you think? Maybe three teams or a couple teams where they were good last year, but they're going to stink this year.
That I can give you.
Okay, bang, let's go. Well, I want to hear it.
I'm thinking of TJ Edwards.
Yeah, I'm excited to hear this.
Wait, where should I start? I'll start with Buffalo Bills.
Buffalo Bills, you think they're not going to be good?
Not too high on the Buffalo Bills.
Why is that?
No. I think it's time. I just... There's been so much talk around the Buffalo Bills, and they just never really comes to fruition. It's always just hype, and then... What am I trying to say? It's like a huge build up, and then it just all comes crashing down. They can't win the big games.
Okay, that's fair.
Josh Allen has not been able to win the big games, and I don't know. I'm just not high on the pill.
So, do you think they win the division, or do you think Jets or Miami take it?
I think. It's tough. Predictions are tough, man.
Yeah, they are.
I can look at the schedules. I think like 11-6, maybe like the Jets and the Bills both go like 11-6, and maybe like a tiebreaker like comes down to it. I'm not gonna say the Bills are gonna be bad. I just think they lose like
they take a step down.
They just lose like two more games this year, and people are like in the offseason, like, well, what's gonna happen to Josh Allen? Or, oh, is Stephon Diggs gonna like want out? Or like,
yeah. That's fair.
They did draft Dalton Kincaid, though, which is one of my favorite picks of the draft. They got him in one of the late rounds, the Utah tight end.
Yeah.
I'm curious to see how they use him in that offense with Josh Allen. He's a good blocker, too. But I don't know. I'm just not high on the Bills. I'm not high on Josh Allen. If there's like one team in the NFL that is like that, I'm just not high on that. Everybody else is the Bills.
That's fair. That's fair.
This year, the other one, the Jaguars. I think the Titans take that division back.
Ooh, really?
I think Mike Vrabel and the Titans take that division back. The Jags got Calvin Ridley. Everybody's talking about that, but I remember Doug Peterson's first year with the Eagles. And he put the birds on the map, and everybody thought. I think he might have won coach for the years first. It was the first year he took the birds to the Super Bowl. It might have been. But after that, he dropped off a little bit. So I'm thinking maybe it's like a 9-8 season for the Jags. Maybe like the Titans go 9-8 too. And it's kind of the same situation last year. Titans almost made the playoffs last year. It came down to that last game of the year with the Jaguars, and Miles Jack returned that Josh Dobbs fumble for a touchdown. The Jags ultimately made the playoffs. I don't think the gap between those two teams is as far as people are making it out to be. Plus, they got DeAndre Hopkins and Ryan Tannehill's back.
That's an interesting take. I think everybody's forgetting about that too, bro. Like, was it D Hop that said, "I'm going to play football until I don't get a 1,000-yard season," or something like that. I think it was him. It was either him or Devontae Adams that said that. But people forget, bro, Hopkins is top five wide receiver in the league, man. And Ryan Tannehill's going to love that. He's going to love just chucking the ball up. And guess what? If you lock up Hopkins, you got to go try and tackle Bulldozer. That's going to come from behind the line at Derrick Henry. And
Treylon Burks gets to be number two now.
Yeah. And the Titans always have a, you know, smash mouth hard defense too. Like, they're gonna hit you and all that. Like, they're tough. So that's I didn't hear that though. I didn't hear anybody. Everybody's been praising the Jaguars. I agree. I mean, I'm also, Calvin Ridley is legit. I mean, I know he was out for a season, but awesome. People forget the last, like, he went crazy on the Falcons when Julio was still there. Like, when Julio was still, like, relevant. Which he fell off, Julio Jones.
I know. Very drastic.
Yeah, what's he doing these days? Did Matt Ryan make Julio Jones look good?
Well, definitely not. I mean, dude, he just got old, and his body gave up on him. But he was on the Titans. No, the Titans had him for a grip last year.
He was on the Buccaneers, too, with Brady.
He was on the Buccaneers, yeah. Very drastic. I mean, he'll be a Hall of Famer.
But I like that. I like that. I am I'm not big on the Giants.
Those are my two. Yeah, you could say, I feel like the Giants will be the same-ish.
Because they made the playoffs last year, like, barely, but got smoked, right? By the Birds. Yeah. Grinning there, yeah. I don't know. I don't really like the Giants. I think there's a lot of drama, and honestly, here's a little bold take, and I hate to, like, say injuries and all this. I think Saquon might get hurt, but not like a very serious injury, but he's going to hold out and be like, well, they're not going to pay me anyways, so why go out on the field for a team? Like, I might as well just rest up. And I saw somebody say this earlier. I think he should request a trade, and you know where I want him to go. Chicago. I think him and Justin Fields would be sweet.
That'd be
together.
Cool, that would be a cool duo.
I think that'd be sweet. Plus, Chicago would actually pay him, which is
they don't have a problem giving out money.
Yeah, and he deserves that. But yeah, I don't. The Giants are my team. Where I'm not, I think there's just a lot of internal. You know, it's like when you're about to break up with your girlfriend and like, you're waiting for that big fight, and you guys all know it's going to come. It's just a matter of when. I think that's going to come up for the Giants sometime this season. I'm telling you.
I wouldn't hate seeing that.
But Birds still take that division 100%.
Yeah. I'll agree with you there. I don't know if I have a third one, but the Bills, the Bills and the Jags are definitely my two. My two in that department.
But what are we saying? NFC South, definitely the worst division. Buccaneers, Saints, Panthers, Falcons. I mean, it's cool. We'll see Bijan and Bryce Young and all that. But
the AFC South is pretty bad, too.
The AFC South?
I think the Colts will be pretty, pretty.
Yeah.
CJ Stroud.
And then you got two rookies in there. Yeah. You got Anthony Richardson, too. How do you feel about the Broncos? Do you think Russ is going to cook?
No.
No?
I lost all, like, I guess respect is the wrong word, but I was never a huge Russell Wilson guy. But after last season, I feel like he ain't him anymore.
You're not riding with Broncos country?
I mean, the dude was doing high knees on the plane, and then he proceeded to get his ass whooped in the next game.
Yeah, no, that's fair. I'm not high on them either. I'm not defending. Plus, Judy's that, out and Hamler's out,
and KJ's out, and I just
yeah, he's throwing what to Cortland Sutton. That's his wide receiver number one.
Yeah, who did they I don't think they had a good head coach hire. I don't think I like their head coach hire.
No, isn't it it's Sean Payton.
Oh, it's Sean Payton.
It's Sean Payton.
I don't like Sean Payton at all, like as a person.
Yeah.
After that bounty gate.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's
even if that's put past him. I just he's been out of the league for a while, man.
He has been. Yeah, no, I agree with you, man.
They could be a dumpster fire. They really could be.
The Broncos.
Denver, yeah.
Yeah, dude, I think so,
too.
They
were pretty bad last year, so they'll just...
It'll just be even more of like a, what the heck are we doing?
They'll just, the smoke and the flame will just get bigger.
I think one more team I want to show love to is, I think, the Chargers. Mm. I think the Chargers are going to be pretty nice this year, but they kind of have the same story as the Bills, where they collect all these wins, but then when a big game comes, they fold. They can't win those big games. But
they just blow the lead. They can't win close games. They're just cursed. Like there's gonna be a 30 for 30 like in like 20 years about how the Chargers of like the 2000s were just cursed.
Yeah,
like the most they lost, like
just all the talent, all the talent that's been on that team throughout the years too, and they just can't get it done. Yeah. They'll be a fun team to watch though. Yeah. They're gonna be all yeah. Like I'll definitely be tuning in to some of their possessions, but I don't know. I just want to give some love to the Chargers and then Jets too. I mean, I think like there's a lot of hype with the Jets, and yeah. I agree that they're probably gonna make the playoffs, but I think they're a little bit too young, and I think their egos are getting a little bit too big because Aaron Rodgers is in the locker room. And I love A-Rod. I think a lot of people don't like him, and I don't really understand all that, but I just don't – when you have the Chiefs and you have the Bills, like I know we just harped on the Bills. I still think Bills are going to beat the Jets if they go in the playoffs, they play against each other. I think the Chiefs are going to win. Bengals will beat them. Ravens will be an interesting kind of game. If the Steelers make it, I mean, Jets are going to beat the Steelers probably. But that's just because I don't know how Kenny Pickett's going to look. Like, that's just kind of how that all transpires. But the Jets will be good, but they're not going to be as good as everybody's saying they are.
I feel like they're going to get out of the gate hot. They got a tough schedule, I think. But I feel like they'll get out of the gate hot, but then, like, lose some of that steam. They should make the playoffs, though. I'll be surprised if they don't. I mean, Aaron Rodgers, I think Garrett Wilson's going to have a huge year.
Yeah, oh, 100%.
Immensely talented, and he's got a guy like A-Rod throwing him the ball. And Alan Lazard to his other side.
Mm-hmm.
And
like Dalvin Cook behind him.
Oh, my gosh, yeah, they did get
that. Yeah, you forget about Dalvin Cook.
They should make the playoffs. I like my prediction of the Bills and Jets like going 11-6, and then
yeah, like, no, I like that too.
Get a wild card and someone gets someone win the division.
How are you liking Miami? Since we're
I was
talking
just,
about
yeah,
this
I was
division.
Just thinking about the Dolphins. I like them better than the Pats.
Yeah, it's fair.
predictions are hard because people get hurt and
yeah, no, it's
like it's
true.
A long season. Prediction like this is the I did this same episode last year with like on Sports with the Z, and I found it like the hardest to do.
So difficult, yeah.
Just to like talk about stuff that like not that like hasn't happened, but. Like predictions are hard to do and like make like content out of, because it's all just kind of like none of it's real. It's just like,
yeah, none of it. Yeah, yeah. We're gonna 6 weeks from now we're gonna be saying the exact opposite things because well we actually get to see how they play. But I kind of dude, I might be the only Tua Tagovailoa supporter. I love Tua. And I love Mike McDaniels. I just, and it's Miami. Like, I'm a Heat fan, but, like, Miami Dolphins, I still get a lot of their news. They got Tyreek, Waddle. I thought they were going to get Taylor there for a second. But they also got Jalen Ramsey as a corner, Chubb. Like, they got all these, like, when you look at it on paper, it's like, wow, it's a good team. Now, they have to play, and the offensive line has to, like, actually block for Tua so he doesn't actually die out there. Felt so bad for him. He was getting rocked, concussions and all that stuff. But
yeah, it looks like he's – did you see the video of him? There's someone tweeted out a video of him falling back. Like it was a similar hit where he got like checked and he like fell back, but he like used his momentum and like carried it into the fall and like did like a somersault roll and like took the momentum off of the back of his head. It's like people have been working with him.
Yeah, that's good.
So he's learning. So that's definitely good to see. If he stays on the field, yeah, they got some dogs on that offense. I mean,
yeah,
Jalen Waddle and Tyreek Hill might be the best wideout duo.
Oh, no doubt. I mean, maybe
AJ.
I'm about to say maybe Smitty and AJ. You could argue, but like
a lot of good ones.
Like Tyreek Hill could have a 2,000-yard season. He was going to have a 2,000-yard season if Tua didn't get hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's. Insane. That's insane, though.
And yeah, you said Mike McDaniel, my favorite head coach next to Nick Sirianni.
Culture guy.
X's and O's genius. And
yeah.
Players coach, too.
Like, yeah, he's a players guy. Yeah, 100%. And he's funny. He's funny.
Oh, he's a goon, man.
He's a good dude. But yeah, no.
But yeah.
Super Bowl prediction? I mean, obviously, I knew
this was gonna come up, and I feel like I'm biased, but I feel like I'm not. I think the Birds get back.
Oh, I 100%.
I just don't see anyone in the NFC.
Yeah.
Dethroning them, I think Jalen's just gonna get better.
Like, the Niners are there, but we saw what happened to them. Damn. Cowboys are there, but I don't really think, and like that's it. As far as the teams I see, that's it.
Cowboys lost Kellen Moore. They got a little more. I like the Brandon Cooks addition. I like Tony Pollard a lot, but they lost Kellen Moore, so we'll see how that shakes out. But there is no reason that the Eagles should progress. I think they're only gonna get better.
Only thing I will say is you guys have like the hardest schedule this season.
We do have a tough schedule.
Like
yeah.
you're gonna get but that's almost you would almost want that when it comes to Super Bowl time because it's like. We've been playing like this. Every game's been a Super Bowl in our eyes because how the competition is. So I agree with you, though. I don't – again, it's the 49ers and the Cowboys, and I don't even want to count the Cowboys, but I feel like I have to because they're just their top team there. But 49ers, I don't – 49ers confuse me, like, so much because there's so much talent and they always perform. But, like, it puzzles me when you have, like, CMC, Debo, Ayuk – Kittle, and then defensively, your top three defense, and you just can't do it. Can't get over that hump. Like, they've won big games. They've lost a lot more big games. But they've always been, for, like, the past 5-6 years, on, like, they're tasting a Super Bowl, whether they're in it or in their conference finals. But I don't see the Birds losing. I don't. They got better somehow.
Jalen is not losing to Brock Purdy.
Yeah. It's just, and your Birds are going to be number one seed. You're not winning a primetime game in Lincoln Financial Field in Philly. Like, no. No, it's just not going to happen.
I have such a hard time seeing the Eagles not getting back. That people talk about the loss of Javon Hargrave. Okay, we picked Jalen Carter.
Yeah.
The best player in the draft who is looking phenomenal in training camp, preseason. Jordan Davis hopefully takes a step this year too. Running game, I mean, we got DeAndre Swift. I think our running game this year is better than it was last year with Miles Sanders. I think Sanders left a lot to be desired sometimes, especially with the Eagles' offensive line.
Yeah.
Swift, Gainwell, Rashad Penny. I think the days of the bell cow are over. I think it's an RBC league now, and I think the Eagles got one of the best ones.
Dude, I couldn't have said it.
Running. And you got Jalen.
And you got A.J. Brown and Devontae Smith on the outside.
And they just picked up – they just traded for that Broncos tight end who's should be a nice red zone threat, just another weapon.
Yeah.
For the Birds, you know, linebacker, lost T.J. Edwards. We'll see. Linebacker and safety, we'll see. But
it's probably the only holes.
Yeah.
But
if you want to call them holes. But,
I wouldn't,
some guys.
Yeah,
Reed Blankenship should take a step up this year.
Shout out to the Eagles having a white corner out there, man.
Yes,
love
sir.
That. Love that.
Yes,
never
sir.
See that.
No, I think I can count on my two hands how many there have been in NFL.
Yeah, so I love that.
Bird's got one of them repping, and he's great. The Eagles brass is saying a lot of great things about him, in terms of like his training camp and preseason performance. So
it's good.
Love to see it. Good vibes for the Birds this year. I think we get back. Hopefully, I'm gonna go and if they make it again, I'm gonna feel like I have to go and see them. But that's a conversation for another day.
AFC, what about AFC team? Yeah, who's the AFC team? It's gonna be a rematch.
I think it could definitely be a rematch.
Yeah.
Although the Bengals, I think it could be the Bengals' year. They got to – I don't want to say it's do or die for them this year because it's not, but this is probably the last year they'll have their three wideouts. I think Joe Mixon's a free agent. This is probably the best offensive line that they've had. Has to stay healthy. Just to switch it up, I'll say Eagles-Bengals.
Yeah. No, I like that a lot as an AFC North kind of rival.
They both lost one, so they're both going to have a chance to, you know, redeem themselves.
I think I saw something like that like a quarterback's to go to the Super Bowl or something in their second year, like failed to go back ever again. And they were like
it was quarterbacks who lost their first Super Bowl appearance.
Lost their first Super Bowl appearance, So
they didn't go back again.
And they never went back again. There we go. Yeah. I like that a lot. I don't know. I think I'm going to have to lean more for the rematch, though, just because it would hurt my soul to see an AFC North team not name the Steelers in the Super Bowl. But I do – they're going to win that division. I'm, like, bias aside, like, Steelers are – there's levels to the game, and Bengals are just a level above. So – I like that. And then what, Birds win? Because I'd root for the Birds. I ain't rooting for the Bengals in that scenario. Yeah, Birds are going to win.
Birds are winning. I can't in my head physically
say they'll lose.
I can't deal with that. I can't deal with back-to-back Super Bowl losses.
Back-to-back heartbreak.
I don't know how the Bills fans in...
Oh, my gosh.
Whenever the 80s or whatever, the Four Falls of Buffalo, I don't know... I would, like, never watch football. After 3 years, I would never watch it. I'd never want to watch again.
Yeah. Oh, dude, did you watch that 30 for 30?
Yes.
Oh, such a good one. But, yeah,
it
dude, that's...
very good. But it wrenched my soul. I felt, like, for Jim Kelly, I felt so bad. Like, it sucks. Just, like, it's
heartbreak.
Just get one. Like, come on.
Just heartbreak. Yeah. Really All is. Right, but I'm still going to go Patty Kelsey, though.
Can't go wrong with
that. They'll be there. But I would still say I think Birds win it all. How long is A.J. Brown under contract for? Is he a free agent next summer?
No, Smitty will be before him. We traded for him and signed him to a 4-year deal.
Oh, okay.
We got him. Smitty's the one we're going to have to worry about because he's still on his rookie deal. Which
yeah.
is not this offseason, I think, but the next one?
I would almost, like, if you had to choose one, who would you want?
Dude, this was that's a tough question. Eagles Twitter, like, the other week because Devontae or somebody said something about that Devontae could be the best wide receiver in the league one day. Might have been one of the Eagles coaches. I forget who said it. But then AJ was asked about that in during media or whatever, and he was just like, he's like, man, I don't want to play those games. Like, I don't want to compare. Like, he's great. Like, I'm great. Like, appreciate us both while we have us. And I was like, damn right.
Perfect,
like,
answer.
I'm going to. I do. Like, I'm so – they're both so good. Like, I think they could both be top 10.
Yeah. I saw somebody drafted their fantasy team, and they had Devontae and A.J. Brown as their wide receiver 1 and 2, which is not bad. You might as well just pick up Hurts, though. Your bye week might be crappy, but soak up the loss. Doesn't matter. You'll win the rest of the games.
Yeah, work around it. But, yeah, to answer your question – My, I hate this question. Why do you do this to me? This is not a fun question. Why does my like head say AJ, but my like heart says Smitty? I don't know. We drafted Smitty, but AJ's such a beast. Probably AJ Brown.
You would want him.
I hate that there's like a little. You forced me to choose, so
yeah,
it doesn't really justify this. There's a little like a little guy in my head that's, I mean, AJ's been hurt too, but like Smitty is gonna like get hurt or something. I don't know. I don't think he will, but like he is, you know, on the smaller side. I always get so scared when he gets rocked, but he's just gonna get back up.
Yeah, like, he's smaller.
He's
smaller though, but AJ Brown is a beast. So
you can't.
That's respectable.
I hate that question.
That's respectable. I would almost pick Smitty.
I don't know. I like them both.
But hey, you have them both, so it doesn't.
Yeah, facts.
Doesn't, and you'll have them both next season too. So probably, I think Eagles will.
I wonder.
Do everything
I wonder
can.
Who's gonna be good, better, have a better career when it's all said and done.
AJ or Smitty? I don't know.
I mean, that's kind of what I was like thinking along those lines. But we drafted Smitty, and I was so excited when we got him because we jumped the Giants, and we screwed the Giants out of getting him. And I'll never forget that. That was such a great feeling when we were so desperate for a wide receiver, like Travis Fulgham
yeah.
was our leader, and he barely had 500 yards.
Yikes! Yeah.
But I was so hyped when we traded for AJ too.
On the west side of the state, we never have to worry about wide receivers. So Steelers always find wide receivers.
Yeah, that's
always.
True.
Always.
Literally.
But I hope Pickens is a like lifer.
I think Pickens and Freiermuth aren't lifers, someone needs to be fired.
No, I'm all on that board, yeah. Yeah, I remember when we picked George Pickens, like my roommate's a Georgia fan, and I was like, I don't really remember him, and they like showed like a highlight, and it was just him like rocking somebody, and I'm like, yep, I could dig this. I could get this guy. Okay. And then that photo of him like sitting in front of the TV with the shiesty on.
He's
like,
a dog.
Yeah. He's a dog. Literally a dog.
Yes.
It's George Dog. But alright, I like that. Time will tell. Time will tell.
I hate that question. And I'll go soft answered.
That's fair.
Amen.
Hey, man, I respect it.
Yeah.
I hate that
we have to end on the question.
Anything else on your mind there, Zachary?
Whew. Not really.
Yeah, I mean.
Hour 20 minutes.
That's.
Solid first
episode. I'm saying, bro, we're going hard here, folks.
We are.
First episode. Come on, I mean, this ain't no...
could preview the NFL season for like ever. There's so much to talk about. We didn't even hit on half the like teams and such.
Yeah, no, but general knowledge there. College even, we had 30 minutes on, man. We got we got takes, bro.
We got takes for days. Takes for days from Zach and Prime.
It's Zap, baby. You know the name. You know it.
Yeah, I'll give you give me the credit for the intro. I'll give you the credit for the name. That was all you.
Let's go. Let's go, baby. It works. If y'all think we're just going to do a podcast, like, nah, just wait. Wait for 5 years down the road to see what Zap is. I'm telling you. Hop on the bandwagon now.
Hop on the wave. Ride.
It's like Dion, baby. I think I can. We're all on that. We're all on that.
Little engine that could. We'll be here every week. Starting off once a week. Probably doubling that. And like Toby said, got a lot of great stuff coming your way, not just in podcast form, but in other mediums as well. Stay tuned, stay locked in to Zach and Prime, the Zap Show. That'll do it for our first episode. Toby, where can they find you on the socials?
I'm a big Twitter guy. Toby, T-O-B-E-Y, _ Prime. And then Toby Prime on Instagram if you care about what I post on there. But follow me on Twitter, though. And then LinkedIn, we're looking for jobs, baby. Toby Prime, I'm there. But, yeah, that's me. If you want to follow me, I would love to have you on. Slide in my DMs. Do what you need to do. I'm usually on Twitter a lot, so I guess it's X now, though. So yeah, X, my bad, Elon. But, yeah.
It's always going to be Twitter. It's just like you see Shannon Sharp on Stephen A's show.
Skip.
I called him Skip.
Skip. Oh, my bad.
Can't blame the guy.
Can't blame him.
But you can find me on X at @ZachDonaldson_, as well on Instagram, too, if you want. But LinkedIn, I mean.
Hit us up.
Looking for work. Just take a chance.
Take a chance
on you boys.
Take a chance.
We won't let you down.
Yeah, never.
But in the meantime and beyond, this is where we'll be. It's Zach.
And Prime. That's the name.
It's the Zap Show. Thank you for tuning in. Till next time. Peace.
Peace.